That's all it is, Miles. A leap of faith.
Like, what's up, danger? Like, what's up, danger? Like, what's up, danger? Like, what's up, danger?
Made them myself. They fit perfectly.
What is going on, my beautiful DC brothers and sisters? It's your boy, The Truth 31. Hit like, subscribe for all that DC goodness on the face, neck, and chest. And we're sitting on 2 years to the day that Spider-Verse came out, that great movie. And I wanted to talk about just my overall feelings on Miles Morales. Now, I read the Ultimate series by Brian Michael Bendis, who right now just did a horrendous job on butchering, mutilating Superman. Like, I think Brian Michael Bendis is the real life Lex Luthor, because I think he just completely destroyed Superman. I think he's a combination of Lex Luthor and Joss Whedon. So there you go. I'm sure he's a lovely human being, but his run on that was not so great. And I read his run on Ultimate Spider-Man, and again, I'm not a fan. I just did a video on this whole Black Batman and the tokenization of comic book characters on white comic book characters. And I wasn't a fan of what they were doing with Peter Parker and Spider-Man. I was just like, okay, here we go. I know Marvel at the time wanted something new. They wanted something fresh. They wanted something to intrigue and engage the readers once again. So they like, okay, well, let's hire this Puerto Rican Black Spider-Man. Now, you know, I'm Puerto Rican, he's Puerto Rican, Boricua all day, and he's Black, of course. So I'm just like, okay, well, let me see what they're going to do with him. Let me see what new tricks they have up their sleeves. And I read the book, and I wasn't impressed. I gotta be honest. I was not impressed in the slightest. I was just like, okay, because there was nothing unique. There was nothing special. There was nothing. There wasn't that X factor that made him so different from Peter Parker. Other than, you know, he had the powers of invisibility and he had like the Venom Strike, which is like the Venom powers and stuff like that. I was like, okay, that's cool. But cool powers isn't something that I care about. I care about the character. Like, what can you make me do to like really impress me and engage with the character? Like, build the character up. Like, what is he like? What music does he listen to? You know, who is his family? Who is his parents? Who's his love interest? You know, all the character traits that make a character interesting. And I just didn't feel it with Miles Morales. And of course, you know, at that time you had two sides, right? You had the one side who was like super excited about this. Like, yeah, we're getting a minority Spider-Man. This is awesome. This is what we need. And then you had the other side, which is like, oh man, Black Spider-Man, why are you doing this? You're forcing these diversities on my throat again. Of course, and both sides, to be honest, annoy me. I don't like both sides. Me, I'm a normal person, so I was right down the middle. I wanted to give it a fair shake and a fair shot. And I read it, and I was just like I said, I just wasn't impressed because it was nothing new. There was nothing about this character that had me interested, that had me engaged. Like there was nothing different about him other than, you know, he took the moniker Spider-Man, which is I went on a whole nother thing about comic book writers, you know, with tokenizing the characters and just giving him the name Spider-Man to help sell this new character, because the comic book writers are afraid that if they create a new character, it's not going to sell. Now, I understand that. I can dig that. I understand that, you know, it's a hard sell for new readers to pick up a new character that's not already established. I understand that, but again, that, like, you know, tough shit. Excuse my language. You know, that's your job. Your job is to make the character interesting and intriguing. So, you know, do your job. But so that was like a whole nother tangent I went on. But I was just like, okay, whatever. I just ignored it. Didn't even move on. I just moved on, moved past it. Wasn't my thing. And then I saw Spider-Verse in 2018 in theaters. And when I saw that movie, I was just like, wow. You know what? It finally clicked with me why Miles is really underrated and why people like Miles. Like I got it. because there was character development to the character. He had tics, he had quirks. I understood his motivation. I knew what kind of music he liked. I knew his friends. I knew his family, his mom and his dad. Is it an important essential to his character? He has uncle who he had a loving relationship with, who turned out to be the Prowler, like a main villain. So there was like, you know, there was this intrigue and mystery to, like, you know, and this antagonistic relationship between him and the Prowler, not knowing that, you know, they're family. So there was intrigue there. And of course, you know, he's dropping the, you know, Puerto Rican flag and stuff like that. Of course, you got to represent. So I was like, it finally clicked with me. It was like, okay, now I get it. Now I understand. Now I actually like Miles. Now I want to root for Miles. And of course, you know, the PS5 game came out. Hashtag secure the 5. I haven't gotten the 5, and I will not play Miles Morales until I secure the 5. I got to get that. I'm not playing on PlayStation 4. No. I got to get the 5, and then I'll play. And of course, you know, I've seen bits and pieces of the story of Miles Morales, and I'm just like, oh my God. I'm just amazed. Because like this, like, I'm watching a story in a video game form, and I watch Spider-Verse, and I'm like, yo, why wasn't any of this in the comic book series, in the Ultimate series, I believe, right? Like all of this interesting character development stuff and his character traits, this wasn't in the book. Now, it might have been for some people, but for me, it just didn't resonate with me in the comic books. I was on the side of the people who was like, yo, why are you doing this? This is just a carbon copy of Peter Parker, except he's Black and Puerto Rican. Like, there's nothing special about him. What's special about him? Until I saw Spider-Verse, and I was like, oh, okay, there it is. That's why he's special. It's like, I got it. It clicked with me. And I think one of the writers, too, of Spider-Verse were Black. And I think the directors were Black, and the writers were the same writers who did the 21 and 22 Jump Street movies, which is hilarious, which is why that script is so good, because it's funny, and it had heart, it had humor to it. And you felt for Miles. Like, you understood his background, you understood where he came from, you know, you understood everything about him and his world and living in Brooklyn. I lived in Brooklyn. It's like, yo, I related to Miles Morales in the movie form and not in the comic books, which is, again, a strange thing, because you would think, you know, I'm a big comic book head, so you would think, oh, okay, well, if I read the comics, I'm going to understand this character. But the movie did it better, way better. And of course, you know, the video games just took it and the video game story, they took that football and just ran with it. And of course, you know, now, like, Miles Morales is a household name, but he's also different from Peter Parker. He's also different from Spider-Man. Like, even though he still has the moniker of Spider-Man, and he's still, you know, in a way, a tokenized character in that sense, but I feel like now that there's so much difference between him and Peter Parker that I feel like people who are still calling him a tokenized character is a little unfair. Like, I understand where people are coming from, where he's like, hey, he took the name of Spider-Man. I get that. I understand that. But again, like I said, there's so much nuance to him. There's so much differences with him and Peter Parker. And so much character development given to Miles Morales that I feel like, okay, well, now he's no longer a tokenized character in the full sense. Like, now he's his own man, he's his own name, and hopefully, you know, people are starting to realize that. It's like, okay, but people who are on the fence now realize that he's a great character. So, but anyway, those are my thoughts. Smash that like button, my beautiful DC brothers and sisters. Subscribe, hit me on Twitter, Instagram. Let's continue having a DC conversation. As always, support DC, love DC, and support Miles Morales, because Miles Morales is awesome. I love him, and, you know, shout out to Spider-Verse, and shout out to everyone. All right, love you all. Peace out.
Met my roommate, finally. Slapped a sticker where my dad's never gonna find it. And when I feel alone, like no one understands what I'm going through, I remember my friends who get it. I never thought I'd be able to do any of this stuff, but I can. Anyone can wear the mask. You could wear the mask. If you didn't know that before, I hope you do now. because I'm Spider-Man. And I'm not the only one.